Apostles and saints filled the iconostasis with their adoration, culminating in a crucifixion like a shout of victory. For the death of Christ means only triumph to the Orthodox. Not for them the grief and the passion beloved of the Roman Church, nailed hands and broken heart. These, instead, are turned into an intellectual and mystical vision, whose protagonists are portrayed as figments of heaven, floating in an abstract calm. Softly, like drowsing bees, the voices asked forgiveness. The same cry as had punctuated the liturgy for 1300 years. Peace unto all. Love we one another. One by one, the drama unfurled its ageless beauties. The litany of peace, the cherubicon, the triple great blessing, the hymn of heavenly victory, reaching at last to consecration and the awed hush of the metusis. The brethren looked comfortably settled into their chanting, as if it would last all day or all eternity. The Canterbury monk stifled a yawn. Along the iconostasis, I noticed the saints were not all impeccable Christians. Here and there a pretense had worn thin, or a mask had slipped. Saint Demetrios, on his red charger, is understudy for Demeter, the corn goddess. Saint Dionysius stands in for his heathen namesake, and the white-horsed Saint George may have ousted Adonis. Reconsecrated pagans, they have put on the dress of Christian sobriety. Beside the Virgin's icon, like tribute to her older self, a wax baby lay on its back, a votive offering, either in thanks or in hope, of childbirth. But she herself, flanked by her ambiguous saints, was half veiled in a cloth of seed pearls. Only her lap and hand were visible, enclosing, in glimmering repoussé, the disturbingly mature child.